Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast episode 1644, copy from each filtered worksheet. Today's question is sent in by Leon. Leon said that he has a macro, and this macro is set up to copy the previously filtered records from each worksheet in a workbook. But the problem is that he's getting the headings in each one. So let's run the macro that I imagine that Leon has. We'll click run. And sure enough, you see what's happening is we're getting the headings from each of the worksheets. And so is there some way to not copy those headings? So let's just come here. We're going to take a look at Monday, and we're going to switch back and forth between VBA code. I'm just going to use the immediate window down here at the bottom. So if I say, tell me what the active cell dot address is, you'll see that I'm currently in A2. So from there, take a look. See, it's just A2 is selected. If I say active cell dot current region dot select, you'll see that instead of just A2, we now have however many rows, however many columns. We have the whole data set. So that's good. Switch back to VBA. Here is what I think we need to do. Instead of saying active cell dot current region dot select, if we say active cell dot current region dot offset one row down, zero columns to the right dot select, I think that will make sure that we select everything but the headings. So I'll press enter here. We'll go back. Look at that. So that moved my whole selection down one row. All right, now I can already hear what you're saying. You're saying, "Oh wait, that's no good because you're going to get this blank row." But I think that's okay because we're going to copy all of these records, including the blank row, to the summary worksheet. And then we're going to go to Tuesday and copy all of these records, including the blank row, to the summary sheet. And we'll overwrite the blank row from the previous time. That's my goal. All right, so taking a look at the code that we have up here. For each worksheet in activeworkbook.worksheets, make sure that this worksheet name is not equal to summary. If that's true, figure out where the next row on the summary is going to be. So we start at the bottom of the summary, press the N key and the up arrow key or control up arrow, see what row that is, plus one. And then we start at, we don't have to start at A2, we can start at A1. From A1, the current region dot offset 1, 0 dot. And then special cell selects only the visible cells, the copy, this is a continuation character here, and the destination is going to be the summary worksheet. The next row, that's a variable, (1). All right, so with that one simple change, let's come back to our summary worksheet, and we'll do just Alt F8 to get a list, copy all, click run. There we go. So we are getting everything without the headings. Now, of course, we're not even getting the headings on the first one, so either you have to put those in manually or add one line to the macro. But I think to solve Leon's problem here, all we need to do is add the offset. Great little function in VBA. Not as complicated as the offset function in regular Excel. This just says, hey, we're going to move one row down, zero columns over, and it keeps that same shape of the selection, but moves it down. Hey, I want to thank Leon for sending that question in. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time. Another netcast from Mr. Excel.